Help me, darling, my heart has spoken. I hear you say, Reagan, founder and president of Vision Miracle Church of God Evangelistic Association. Bishop Juliet Fagan is married for over 34 years to Bishop Leroy Fagan, professor of biblical systemic theology. She's an ex-police in Royal Cayman Island Police Force, trained nurse, certified neuropathic practitioner, colon care specialist. She's also a local and international speaker. She's a Facebook video blogger. And there is so much more that we can say about Bishop Juliet Fagan. But most of all, she is saved and is serving the Lord and living a God's life. If you are sitting, I'm asking you please to stand and help me welcome Bishop Juliet Fagan.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let me hear somebody praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, if you come to worship the Lord tonight, why don't you just clap your hands for the Lord? Praise the Lord. Such a great honor and privilege of mine to be in the house of God. I want to say praise God. I want to thank God for your praise God, your brave and awesome leader. Praise God. Won't you put your hands together for Pastor Abdul? Praise God. Pastor, come here, sir. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor's got a man of many words. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 He said, I must just do what I have to do. He's got a man of many words. Well, put your hands together for him. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And you know, I just want to give God thanks for Minister Acosta. Thank God for you too. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Put your hands together for her. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. I don't know about you, but just raise your hands to the Lord tonight. We're going to have church. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. No matter what, you know, I love to make sure that I greet the host and hostess of the church. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I want to thank God for Bishop Leroy on the camera. And I just want to thank God for him. Amen. I want to thank God for Deaconess Powell and Exhorter Alicia, who's there with me tonight. And for all of you on Facebook, praise God, all over the world, wherever you are, praise God. I just want to say, pick up yourself wherever you are. Put your hands together for our audience all over, praise God. It's beyond the four walls. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I know that your scripture is the Great Commission. Praise the Lord. And if there was ever a time that we need a Great Commission and we need to carry it out, it is now. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. But tonight, praise God, I just want you to pray with me. Heavenly Father, Almighty God, Father God, Lord, tonight, oh God, we come, oh God, and we saturate the atmosphere, oh God. Lord, we pull down strongholds. Come on, somebody. Lord, tonight, oh God, we release this place, oh God. We know that the word will go forth. We thank you for this opportunity. We thank you, oh God, for opening doors. We thank you for blessing us, Father. And we just want to say, Father, we thank you for what you're going to do here in this place. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Come on, let's give God a clap. Let's give God a clap. Let's give God a clap. I don't know what you need us to do, but I come to worship the Lord. Come on, somebody. I don't know what we're going to give God. Come on, say it. Come on, say it. Come on, put your hands to the Lord. Come on, just raise up the air like you do there. Come on, come on. Just move this place like you do. Stop on your feet all over. Give me my approval. Get up on your feet and give God praise. Hallelujah. 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 praise the Lord, glory to God. I know, praise God, that you have Matthew 28, praise God, that the Lord has given me a word. Amen?
Yes.
I hope you don't mind, Pastor, for bringing that word, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Turn the Bible, praise God, to Mark 4. Praise God, we want to look at the struggles and storms of life. Come on, somebody. We want to look at the struggles and storms of life. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. I'm just going to read for time's sake. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Mark 4. Read it from 36, praise God, to 41. Praise the Lord. Amen. And when they had sent away the multitude, they took him even as he was in the ship. And there were also with him other little ships. And there arose a great storm of wind. And the waves beat into the ship, so that it was now full. And he was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep. Somebody say asleep.
Asleep.
Somebody say asleep.
Asleep.
He was in the hinder part of the ship, asleep on a pillow. And they awake him, and say unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish? And he arose and rebuked the wind, and said unto the sea, Peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. And he said unto them, Why are you so fearful? Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? 41 at last, and they feared exceedingly, and said one to another, What manner of man is this? That even the wind and the sea obey him. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, we want to look at the struggles. You're going to see this for a few minutes. Praise God. We want to look at the struggles and storms of life. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I just want you to tell somebody, I can't give up now. Come on. Some of you, I don't know what you're getting ready to do tonight. Praise God. But you need to tell somebody, I can't give up now. Come on, somebody. You need to say, I can't give up now. I can't let go now. Oh, come on, somebody. I can't settle now. I can't lower my standard now. I can't give up anything now. I've come too far by faith, leaning on the Lord. Is there anybody here tonight? Come on, guys. I'm going to give you the word. The Lord. How many of you know that God has a plan for you?
Yeah.
I say, how many of you know that God has a plan and a purpose for your life? Come on, I heard that sister. Jose tonight, praise God. I heard her say tonight, you know, that there's a plan and a purpose for your life. Praise God. You just wasn't born to come to church and get saved. And just to sit down, praise God. But we're talking about the Great Commission. Praise the Lord. Come on, somebody. God has a plan and a purpose for every one of us. There is a divine destiny set in motion right now. Come on, I said there is a divine destiny set in motion. Praise God. Something has been released on your behalf.
Yeah.
Come on now. Come on, come on now. Ah, Holy Ghost, come on, Holy Ghost preacher, you know. Praise the Lord. Come on, Church of God. Hallelujah. Don't get quiet on me, because I am a Holy Ghost fire burning devil. Stop me, preacher. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So don't be afraid to drop your hands. Don't be afraid to stomp your feet. God, you thought that when they said it's a boy or it's a girl, come on, Pastor. thing that you're going through.
Yes.
God said, I knew.
Yes.
I knew that you were going through it.
Yes.
Because before you was even, before your daddy even completed with your mama, God, I wish I had some people to say something about it. I wish I had some preachers to help me. I wish I had somebody. God said, I knew you. I knew what color skin you would have. I knew what kind of hair you would have. I knew exactly what you were going through.
Come on,
just tell your neighbor, say, let's show up 3, 4, 5 persons just as she's talking to me. Praise God, technology. Praise God, human technology. Father. Praise God. Hallelujah. Everybody somewhere is trying to outdo somebody. Come on, somebody. Can I preach in this church? Can I preach in this church? Everybody's trying to outdo somebody. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Time to look around, Pastor. Somebody's hustling. Somebody's trying to scam somebody. Somebody's saying, no. But anybody that can't preach with me, and give me a talk. Come on. Anybody that can't say no now. And if you know that I'm talking the truth, everybody's trying to hustle. Come on, somebody. But there are some of us who are up there working the work of him that sent us. Working the work of him that sent us. Yes, my friend. For some of you, it is a struggle to become relevant.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
We're talking about struggle and storms. We're talking about struggles and storms.
Yes.
I say there are some of you under the sound of my voice, you are wrestling and you're struggling
yes.
to become relevant. You want to be accepted.
Yes.
Come on, be careful. How you want to be accepted by everything and everybody. Come on, somebody. Last night I watched the news. CBM. And trust me, never nice at all. Come on, somebody. When you're trying to become relevant, sometimes you're trying to become relevant and you end up making a mess of yourself. Give God a clap in there. You make a mess of yourself. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. How many love it tonight? I am going to land this ship. But somebody's coming out. Somebody coming out. Somebody coming out. Somebody's coming out. Yeah. When you fight to become relevant, sometimes you get angry with everybody else. When you're trying to be relevant, you become envious of everybody else. Some people now say that now. Come on, somebody. You can't stand to see your sister blessed. You can't stand to see nobody blessed. When you're trying to become relevant. But when you are grateful to God, little is much. When God is in it. Come on, somebody. And who God bless? No man bless. I wish there's a heart 12 of you. Praise God. Hallelujah. is about to climb the ladder. Some of you is about to get a breakthrough.
Yes.
Something that you've been praying about, waiting on for a long time.
Yes.
Come on, and if you follow the looks of some people, if you follow the looks of some folks, you'll slip right down.
Yes.
That's why you got to wiggle yourself up. You got to tell yourself, am I going through what I'm going through? Am I facing what I'm facing when I'm coming out? Is there anybody that can show that coming out? Even a few months ago, I was struggling. Yeah, me was struggling to be relevant. And I will say something here, and it might sound like a joke, but you will see what I'm talking about when you look at me good. I was struggling to kill gray hair. But these gray hairs ain't going nowhere. The gray hairs stood up and said enough is enough. I ain't going nowhere. You want to beat me with black Peter, but I ain't moving. I'm going to stay right here. If that was the day when I washed up my hair, then I saw half black and half white. And I said in the name of Jesus, enough is enough. Trying in the church, we mustn't kill them.
at the same time.
Amen.
We have to encourage our young people.
Yes.
Because we are living in some times where these demons and spirits are so dangerous and strong and rampant.
Yes.
So when you see the young girls and the young guys coming to church, no matter take your tradition and your religion from 1942, I explain. Them days, back then, if you even going on a flight, you're dressed like corpus, stockings and hat. I go on plane. When you come off the plane, you can't even walk to get immigration, your foot will kill you. Come on, somebody. Nowadays, you're traveling, you're holding on a jeans pants, and a nice blouse or a t-shirt, and a pair of sandals or a sneakers, and you're going about your business. Come on, somebody. Struggles are real.
Yes.
I said the struggles are real.
Yes.
They are real, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen.
Real.
The struggles are real. Praise God. You got people in church struggling.
Oh, yes.
I know we didn't put it on. You got people in church struggling. Save punk talking demons stopping. People struggling.
Yes.
Going through something. And you see, before you start choking your neighbor, before you start choking your neighbor and say, oh, what is? With that holier than thou self, give me a chance. Because you might be the one to get your breakthrough here tonight. You might be the one to get your breakthrough here tonight. When you are struggling in the physical, everybody can see.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
When you're going through a storm in the physical,
everybody
can see.
Oh, yes.
When you're struggling in the physical there and the people know what you're going through, they can see that the storms are raging, they can see. Somebody say, well, I heard Prime Minister Paula say, if you have an umbrella, what do I do? When you're going through a storm, somebody can say, there is an umbrella. Take like a shelter. Some of you got missing if you don't live there. If you don't understand it. Because they can see what you're going through. They can see that the storms of life is raging. They can see that the rain, oh my God, help me in here. They can see that the rain is coming. And you don't have nowhere to go. So since I got three umbrellas, I'm going to get out of heaven. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. There is no fault After God begins to bless us.
Oh, yes.
Then we forget who God is. You got to be careful. Then we forget who God is. Because I'm telling you, I want to stay under the blood. I know that some of you now get so cool in air condition. Next months. That you can't raise your hands no more. And you can't get up no more. Because you come from terror. But anytime that the right storm hits you. Anytime the right problem hits you.
Everything we put on the
wanted. This is what I wanted. This is a mountain to me. Sometimes everything look nice on the outside, but what about those deep-seated secrets? Camouflaged hurts and pains and bruises and scars. Come on, somebody.
When I see Christians who used to be on fire for God,
It makes no wonder what has happened to your joy. What has happened to your praise? You sit down stiff as a piece of 2x4. Many years ago, you that are clapping and jumping and praise God. And all of a sudden, we can't praise God. Why you remember you have to praise God? The whole hour of it, get up and praise God. Preach with the pastor. Praise and worship and praise God.
Yeah, and then you begin to feel guilty.
because of what they say. But it was Job who said, where is God? God, where are you? Come on.
Right here.
Where are you, God? And I'll paraphrase them and turn. I look to my right. I look to my right, God, and you're not there. Come on, somebody, get in the spirit. Some of you, I look to my left. I know God. I look behind. I look in front of me. I look up. I look down and I cannot find God. But last week I know that God was hearing me. But now the storm is raging. The storm. Oh, we shall have just here.
Shift and roll and walk now. Shift
storm. A lot of things happen when there's a storm. When you have storm, you lose all kind of things. When you have storm, thunder and roll. Come on, talk to me. When you have storm, lightning and flash, you know, preacher, bishop, man. You don't understand what storm. When you have storm, everything shift up. Come on, somebody. Everything shift up. Come to me and say, it's my time. Come on. That's what there is in the middle one. It's my time. Stop trying to fix back things while a storm is going in your life. Storm and blow. Stop trying to have the storm move back your opinion. And I put it back. What God is saying, I am moving some things, I am shifting some things. I am letting you play. I am getting you ready. Can you get me this storm? I'm getting you ready. The storm is flowing. The reason why you have that storm. I preached this word about four times to myself today. Today I preached this word to myself about four times. I look up and I preach it to myself and I got it. Praise God, sometimes God allows some storms to come our way. Not to destroy you, but to clean up some things around you. Stop trying to see God in the storm. This word is for somebody. When storm come in pitch black, light gone, everything dark. I know the fire right here, yes. And I know the spoon right here. Yes. You know, I feel, stand still. Yes. Yes. How many of you? Plant your foot. We walk by faith, yes, and not by sight. God said to remind you, I knew you, yes, and I knew what day the storm will come into you. Yes. I knew exactly what was going to hit you. That God says, stand still. That your neighbor, to your neighbor, says, stand still. Stop right to tell somebody. Just because you can't see God moving how you want it to move. Because how God moved last year, and how God moved in the other thing, and how God moved in the other predicament, you want God to move in the same way. But God said, I've got a big surprise for you. How I'm gonna move, gonna not only shock you, but shock all of them around you who think that you don't. God said, I'm ready to do something that not even you don't understand. Praise God. So stop trying to feel God and tell God what to do. See, storms and struggles come to shake us out of our comfort zone. Amen. Know you're shouting in church. I know you're dancing. Yeah. You're praising God and all of that kind of good thing. I know that God inhabits the praises of men. Come on, talk to me. He inhabits the praises of his people and the praises of men. He dwells in our praises.
Amen.
But if you really want to know where God is, stay in the middle of your storm. I wish I had somebody to clap. Stay right there in the middle. And some of you never got that. If you want to find God, don't try to step up. Stay right there. Stay right there in the middle of the storm. I'm going to give you a word. Praise God. Hallelujah. Stop complaining. Stop worrying. Praise God. Because there was a psalmist, David, who said, are you ready? Are you ready? If you want to know where God is, if you want God to help you, stay right there in that problem. Stay right there in that storm. For he is a present help. Somebody understand. I say, he said, I'm a present. Somebody show present. Right in the middle of your trouble, God said, I'm right there with you. Where are you trying to get on your own? Where are you trying to get on your own? He's right there. Finally. Anytime God is getting ready to do something, he always allows some kind of storm.
Yes, he does.
To blow all the way. But that's all of faith. Everybody stand. Everybody stand. Everybody stand. And if you're ready, and you want me to pray with you, just walk from your seats with your hands raised. I never paid anybody to come. You are only from this church. So I move it toward this altar and get as close as you can. Come on, come on. If you want me to pray with you, I'm prophesying some things here. You want me to pray with you, just walk. If your neighbor don't want to come, that's all right. Some of you wait to see who will move. God bless you. Come in, sir. Just give me some of the thing here. Just come on. If it was me, this whole place would have been packed. This whole altar would have been packed all over the place. I mean, even when your members need prayer. Everybody need prayer. Come on, somebody. I pray as something I never turned down. Come on, there's a lot of space over here. Don't let nobody beat you. Don't let nobody beat you. Don't let nobody beat you. Come on. I'm gonna sing, guys. Because I kind of drop it. Hallelujah. Shake. Kumbaya, baby. Shake, call to our Lord. hands are healed tonight.
With anemia and really, really. Let the blood.
My God.
Hallelujah!
Oh,
you're here tonight. You have not accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and indwelling Savior. This is the hour. It's appointed unto man once to die, but after death comes the judgment. It is not God's will that any should perish, but that all. But all, I'm just going to put it in layman's terms, that every one of you or everybody will come to know Him and receive eternal life. It is not God's will that any should go to hell and perish, but that you be saved. I want to see everybody head bowed, nobody looking around. Nobody looking around. And if you would just stick up your hand and say, Bishop, I'm not a Christian, I love church and I go to church, but I want pastor and I want this church and I want you to remember the prayer. Stick up your right hand fast. Nobody looking around. Nobody, don't disobey. Just stick that hand up. If you want us to remember you in prayer. Don't try to hide. And thank you, sister, for your honesty. It's a dangerous thing to try to hide. Thank you over there. Thank you. Let's stick it up. Hold it up. Hold it up. Is there one more? Stick it up high so I can see it. Come on, hold it up. Hold it up, guys. Yeah, look at that. God bless you for your honesty. I want to ask you to come to the front doors and have your hands. Just give them a little wave. Come here, darling. I want to pray. Hold it. Soul. Is there a kind of something happened. This is Bishop. Now, did you get favored signing off? God bless you. Shalom.